Hey there, folks. I know it's been a while. I'll get to that in a bit. But first off, I've got this battle for you today against Tom and Jared, who I met through the Smogon Wi-Fi Battle Finder. Had this battle basically 2 months ago, and again, I'll get to that. But anyway, he leads off with a Fear Goal. I knew he was leading off with a Fear Goal, and I completely botched his first turn, and it had a huge impact. Anyway, why did I go for Will-O-Wisp rather than Volt Switch? The answer is that's what you do against a level 1 Aeron. Because with the Endeavor and Shell Bell and Sturdy, you have to have some way of taking it out. But so, yeah, you don't do that with Smeargle. The correct answer there was to Volt Switch out, go out into Steelix, and not have my Rotom team, my only fast member of the team, be Sleep Fodder. Anyway, so I've been playing with this team on Pokemon Showdown before this battle, and it was doing fairly well, unless my opponent had a bulk up Gallade. So I see that my opponent has a Gallade, I'm like, please don't be a bulk up Gallade. And as long as it's not a bulk up Gallade, I figure I'm in an okay situation. So anyway, I've put his Tangrowth to sleep. I was really hoping to get Moltres on the switch, but I don't, so that's too bad. Now Moltres comes out, I go for the Sludge Bomb, predicting the switch, and it does do a decent chunk of damage, so I'm pretty happy about that. If I get Rocks Up, I should probably be able to, you know, take it out. Anyway, fearing the Psycho Cut, I'm gonna have to switch out into George the Third. George the Third is a great even though it's specially defensive, it tends to wall all Gallade sets, so now I just have to scout out what kind of moves it has, and I see that it's a bulk up Gallade, because, I mean, the sub is a dead giveaway. I'm like, oh god, and I've got nothing to deal with it, because my Steelix has Dragon Tail instead of Roar, that has now been changed, and my Quillfish at this point did not have Haze. What a difference a Haze makes. I have since made a few changes to this team, namely putting Haze on Quillfish, which involves modifying the set quite a bit, and now bulk up Gallades give me no problems whatsoever. So, yeah, but here there's nothing I can do. There's absolutely nothing I can do against this Gallade, because none of my Pokemon, except for Rotomsi, who's sleeping, are faster, and I've got no way of preventing him from getting up to +6. Quillfish, it turns out, would have been fine to switch in, because he doesn't have the Psycho Cut, but, you know, after a few bulk ups, you know, Quillfish's attacking move is, it has Aqua Jet and Waterfall, neither of which is going to do much damage to a Gallade that's had a few bulk ups on it. So, bulk up Gallade is really, really menacing if you're not prepared for it, and my team, you know, this team has been completely undefeated since I started with it, and since I replaced Dragonair with Steelix. Now, by the way, I've put, I guess you can say that the configuration that had Tangela and not now Amoongus, that team was undefeated, and putting on Amoongus is what screwed me over. But that's not true. Amoongus is a much better Pokemon than Tangela now that it's got its Dream World ability and it's sticking around in RU. But yeah, I mean, 100% accurate for, they both have Regenerate, but also having Leftovers or Black Sludge recovery. And yeah, so they say never to use Black Sludge on any of your Pokemon because, well, what if someone tricks it out? Well, I have two Pokemon on my team who are poison types who can have Black Sludge. So, Black Sludge is actually a good item for me to have because if someone gets locked into tricking it, then I can, you know, screw them over by, like, keeping them having Black Sludge on their team if both my Quillfish and my Amoongus have Black Sludge. But anyway, here I switch out into my Amoongus thinking, well, I don't think he has Psycho Cut, and I should be able to wall his sets pretty well now that I've seen that he has Shadow Sneak. Yeah, so Shadow Sneak is his fourth attacking move. I mean, obviously he has Drain Punch. They all have Drain Punch. And I'm thinking, well, maybe I can break through his subs. And indeed, I'm able to do it in two turns with Sludge Bomb. And my only hope here is that he attacks this turn, not subbing. Although I'm getting him down pretty low, so I've got a lot of hope here that I can just keep him down and you know, maybe pull this off. So he gets off another bulk up. He's still getting up off bulk ups. There's nothing I can do anything to prevent him from getting to +6. But my I should be able to be okay. I mean, I resist his attacks, and Shadow Sneak isn't going to do very much. So here he goes for the Drain Punch, and here's where all my hard work gets completely wiped out. His health gets way too high. Now, I only hope if I get him poisoned, then maybe there's a chance, but I don't get him poisoned. I'm not going to get lucky and get him poisoned this turn. So he's going to go for a sub again, and I am completely and totally screwed. I just got to keep this up, and just hope that there's some possible way I can break through. He's going to go for another Drain Punch. It's going to do a lot of damage. Again, going to get me down pretty low. And at this point, I'm going to have to switch out or I'm going to die. Oh, I go for the Giga Drain, so that should restore my health a bit. I'm going to break through his sub. Oh, yeah, not really. I mean, I'm going to die if I don't switch out. But luckily, I've got Regenerator, so I can feel free to switch out. I'm going to go ahead and switch out into Tuesday, my Quillfish. Get off the Intimidate, which is at least going to lower his attack one stage. Now he's at plus 5 attack, plus 6 defense. And here's the thing. Waterfall at 0, 0, if he had 0 defense, would have easily have broken his sub. But now that he's at plus 6, obviously his defense is... I mean, not obviously I'm not going to break through it. So here the only thing I can do is go for spikes. Maybe I'll get lucky at some point and something weird will happen, and yeah, but I figure the only real thing I can do is set up a few layers of spikes. Of course, he does have the Sandslash, so he could easily spin away those spikes. But yeah, okay, plus 6, Quillfish is still walling the hell out of this guy, that's his Drain Punch, so he's going to go for another Drain Punch. It's going to kill my Quillfish, and there's really nothing I can do. I mean, I really should have resigned on turn, like, 10. Because I realized there was really nothing I could do, even with Outrageous Act, I don't think there's anything I could do. Anyway, now that he's at plus 6, he's going to go for the Shadow Sneak, and that is going to one-hit KO George III, so that's a good reason to have another good reason to have Shadow Sneak on Bulk Up Delayed is that Bulk Up Delayed tend to be pretty slow. Although the Smogon standard Gallade right now has 56 speed EVs, which is up from quite a bit from where it was a few months ago. It just keeps creeping up and up and up. So yeah, here's where the sweeping begins. I send out Hatterack thinking he was going to go for the Drain Punch, and thinking, well, now he can't recover much health, but it doesn't matter, he's at 100% health anyway. So Hatterack is dead, got into my Audino. Maybe I should have dicked around with him and done a Protect, but, you know, whatever. I mean, this game is lost, and there's really nothing I can do. So, go out into Magma, my Among Us. I'm going to switch out again just to get a bit more health back with Regenerator. I actually should have done that. Well, yeah, I should have done that with Audino as well, but oh well. I mean, sent out Among Us, then switched out into Audino for the Death Fodder. Anyway, going to go back out into Among Us. Among Us is my last Pokemon. I think I can take a Drain Punch, but I'm not sure. I do. I survive with 88. I actually go for the Synthesis, thinking, well, you know, his attacks are doing less than half. Maybe I can stall him out. I looked up how many PPs Drain Punch has, and I think it's either 24 or 32. It's something ridiculously high, and I have no hope of stalling him out of Drain Punches. So, and if he crits me, then it's over anyway. So, I'm just kind of wasting both of our time here. I fixed this team later, and you'll see at the end of this video, I uploaded there's a little epilogue where I show you what should have happened in this battle. I actually was hoping to have a rematch with him, and I never do this. I just test it when people are like, hey, you want to have a rematch with me after they beat me, either way. I don't like doing rematches, but this was an exception. I PM him and was like, hey, do you want a rematch? And he didn't ever get back to me. So anyway, here he switches out into Moltres, and I'm thinking, well, if he misses Fire Blast or Air Slash, maybe I can take him out. And then I think, actually, I would be good with the rest of his team, but no such luck. He hits his Fire Blast, and that is a dead Among Us, and that is the end of the battle, and good game, Tom and Jared. So, yeah, that was that. It was really humiliating, but I spent a large amount of time on Pokemon Showdown fixing my team. Well, actually, didn't spend much time fixing my team because there really wasn't anything wrong with my team except for I needed to put Haze on my Quillfish. But this is how this battle should have gone. But anyway, the reason why have I been gone for so long? It's because I got addicted to Pokemon Showdown. I actually ended up laddering really, really high on Pokemon Showdown. On the RU ladder, I think I was like 21 at one point. But yeah, I got caught up in all that stuff, and like, what am I gonna do if Cresselia gets unbanned? Which it was unbanned, and now it's rebanned, so whatever. Anyway, this is how I was supposed to deal with Spiritual. Send out Hatterack as Death Fodder, as Sleep Fodder, excuse me, and then I pretty much wall him unless he has, I guess, Will-O-Wisp, but I outspeed him, there's a good chance I'll wake up before it does anything. So anyway, here's how you deal with Bulk Up Gallade with my team. George III comes out to kind of scope out his set. You know, you don't want to send out Quillfishers in case he has Psycho Cut. But anyway, the idea here is break his sub with Scalds, and it's going to take a few, and he's going to get off some bulk ups, and that's fine. Just, you know, that's fine. Don't worry about it. Just let him bulk up until you break his sub. Now, he's got two choices here. He could either attack predicting my switch, or he can sub. So if he attacks predicting my switch and manages to take out Quillfish, that's fine. I just go out into Rotom C and trick him the scarf, and then that's done. They're not nearly as threatening once they're scarfed. But if he decides to sub, then all I have to do is go for Haze, and since my Quillfish should be EV'd to outspeed, that's 100% guaranteed. And now he's not threatening at all. Even with Psycho Cut, it's really not a big deal. Quillfish can take a few of those, and if he tries to bulk up again, all I have to do is Haze again. You're noticing here that he actually is outspeeding me on certain turns. That's because this Quillfish didn't have enough speed EVs, and there was a speed tie going on. That is fixed. If someone decides to screw me over and run 64 speed EVs on their bulk up delayed, well, then that's just screwing with me, and I don't like that. But whatever. Here's the thing that I wanted to show you. Waterfall will break a Gallade sub, no problem at all. And so, again, Gallade, bulk up Gallade, no longer threatening. So, hope this has been informative. Thank you for sharing in my humiliation. Comment, rate, subscribe, and I should be accepting challenges too. So that's all, and so long. Okay, so I'm gonna resign here, but yeah, so long.